No rest for this royal bridegroom. Newlywed Prince Harry gets back to work after his honeymoon with Meghan by hosting a charity gala with David Walliams. He's just returned from honeymoon with his new bride Meghan, but Prince Harry has wasted no time in getting back to work. The royal last night hosted a summer gala dinner for the charity gala at Kensington Palace in aid of the charity Onside Youth Zones along with comedian David Walliams. Harry, 33, looked in great spirits as he laughed and joked with guests at the event in aid of the charity, which provides spaces for 8 to 19-year-olds where they can enjoy fun and active leisure activities, especially in deprived communities. Host David Walliams reportedly made guests laugh as he introduced the prince as a newly married man, although his new wife Meghan was not in attendance at the event. Businessman Davy Price shared a snap of himself chatting to the prince on Instagram, and said they chatted about the Inspire Youth charity, which his property development company supports, as well as chatting about the pressures young people face on their mental health. He added, "We ma have also talked about helicopters. Absolute gentlemen." The prince looked exceptionally dapper in a tuxedo for the event and took to the stage to make a speech. Guests were later entertained by being treated to a set by 80s singer Rick Astley. Details of Harry and Meghan's honeymoon still remain a closely guarded secret. They remained in the UK for a few days after their wedding and attended a garden party to mark Prince Charles' 70th birthday on the Tuesday after their big day. They have not been seen publicly since, and were rumored to be enjoying a romantic stay at the Fairmont Jasper Park Lodge in Alberta, Canada. According to reports, they finished off their break with a short stay in Ireland, before returning to London. Earlier this week they were rumored to be staying at the 13th-century Ashford Castle in Calne, County Mayo, where rooms cost between £600 and £4,000 a night. The rumor mill went into overdrive after local woman Rachel Ford tweeted, "The first time I go to Ashford Castle and we couldn't get into the actual castle and around it because the royals are within." The sprawling five-star estate, once named as the world's best hotel, is a firm favorite with celebrities including Pierce Brosnan and was the wedding venue of golfer Rory McIlroy when he tied the knot with Erica Stoll in April 2017. It also has a rich royal history. The dining room and bar were named after Harry's great-great-grandfather King George V, one of Ashford's famous guests over the years. Meghan's first post-honeymoon appearance will take place tomorrow, when she joins the royals for her first Trooping the Colour, held in honor of the Queen's birthday. Earlier this week, it was announced that Meghan would be conducting her first joint engagements with the Queen in Cheshire next week. The military parade is attended by senior members of the royal family including Prince Charles, the Duchess of Cornwall and the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. It is not clear if Prince Louis, who is just 6 weeks old, will join his parents at Buckingham Palace, although Prince George and Princess Charlotte are expected to attend, as in previous years. In an unprecedented move, the Duchess of Sussex will be traveling with the head of state on the royal train. Only the most senior members of the royal family, namely the Queen, Prince Philip, Prince Charles and the Duchess of Cornwall, are entitled to use it. Harry, Kate and William are not believed to have ever used it in an official capacity.